Wandering minstrel, Bridget and the cat pram for contributions. While discharging this delicate office, I saw Yum Yum, for we loved each other at once, but she was betrothed to her guardian Coco, a cheap tailor, and I saw that my suit was hopeless. Overwhelmed in despair, I quitted the town. Judge my delight when I heard a month ago that Coco had been condemned to death for flirting. I hurried back in the hope that Yum Yum would be at liberty to listen to my protestations.
It is true that Coco was condemned to death for flirting, but he was freed at the last moment, raised to the exalted rank of Lord High Executioner under the following remarkable circumstances.
Mortify my pride continually. When all of the great slave doctors of state to resign in a body because they were too proud to serve under an ex-tailor, did I not unhesitatingly accept all of their posts at once?
And salaries attached to them, you did.
It is consequently my degrading duty to serve this upstart as First Lord of the Treasury, Lord Chief Justice, Commander-in-Chief, Lord High Admiral, Master of the Buckhounds, Groom of the Backstairs, Archbishop of Titi Poo, and Lord Mayor, both acting and elect, all rolled into one, and at a salary. I, a salaried minion, a boobar paid for his services. But I do it, it revolts me! But I do it,
and it does you credit.
But I don't stop at that. I go and dine with middle-class people on reasonable terms. I dance at cheap suburban parties for a moderate fee. I accept refreshments at any hands.
However, lowly,
I also retail state secrets at a very low figure. Any information about Yum Yum would come under the heading of a state secret. Another insult, and I think a light one.
Young man, despair, likewise go to. Young fair, you must go to. It will not do, I'm sorry for you.
And appears to be as you've recited. But here he comes, equipped to suit his station. He'll give you any further information.
Never will desist. I'm sure they'd not be missed. measure of folks who give an easy and a continental house. It's not the same to hear them shouting, "Fluffy Mickey Mouse," or the British Rail official when services don't go. Lays all the blame on fallen leaves and inappropriate snow. But it really doesn't matter who you put upon the list, or that none of them be missed, that none of them be missed.
He's got them on the list.
About since Edmund School and teachers that I know, like the Scottish physicist and the mad economist, and those mathematics teachers who insist I'm far too slow. Well, then none of them be missed. Then none of them be missed. There's those teachers who bore a safe day with facts of other kinds, like so and so and what's his name and shh, well, never mind. Or the curly one from Wagner House who wishes he was tall, who won around 100 pounds for playing kids. For the tutors who on weekend nights are often rather lit, I think you get my gist. Then none of them.
You may put them on the list. You may put them on the list. I'm not going to be on the list.
My approaching marriage must not be weak. I should like to do it handsomely. And I want to consult you as to the amount I will spend upon them.
Certainly. Say which of my capacities. First Lord of the Treasury. Chancellor of the Exchequer. Privy Purse or as Private Secretary?
Suppose we say as Private Secretary.
Ah, speaking as your Private Secretary, I should say that as the city would have to pay for it, don't stint yourself, do it well.
Exactly. As the city will have to pay for it, that is your advice.
As Private Secretary, although as Chancellor of the Exchequer, I am bound to see that the due economy is observed.
Oh, but you said just now, don't stint yourself, do it well.
As Private Secretary.
No, you say that due economy must be observed.
As Chancellor of the Exchequer.
Ah, I see. Come over here with a Chancellor can't hear us. Now, as my solicitor, how would you propose I deal with this difficulty?
Speaking as your solicitor, I should have no hesitation in saying, chance it.
Thank you.
I will. If it were not that, as Lord Chief Justice, I am bound to see that the law isn't violated.
I see. I'm here the Chief Justice can't hear us. Now, as First Lord of the Treasury.
As First Lord of the Treasury, I could propose a special boat that would cover all expenses. If it were not that, as leader of the opposition, it would be my duty to resist it, tooth and nail. Or as Paymaster General, I could so cook the accounts that as Lord High Auditor, I should never discover the fraud. If it were not that, as Archbishop of City, for it will be my duty to denounce my dishonesty and hand myself over to my own custody as
First Commissioner of Police.
That's extremely awkward. I'm not saying that all of us distinguished people couldn't be, squared. But it is right to tell you that they would not be sufficiently degraded in their own estimation unless insulted with a very considerable bribe.
A matter should have my careful consideration. Oh, my bride and her sisters approach, and any little compliment on your part, such as an abject grovel and a characteristic Japanese attitude, would be esteemed a favour.
No money, no grovel.
Oh, usual, I think. Hey, Minister of Fun!
I haven't known it done.
Thank you. until you are of age.
You forget that in Japan, girls do not arrive at youth discretion until they are 50.
True. From 17 to 49 are considered years of indiscretion.
Besides, a wandering minstrel who plays a wind instrument outside tea houses is hardly a fitting husband for the ward of a Lord High Executioner.
But shall I tell her? Yes, she will not betray me. What if we should prove that, after all, I am no musician?
Dear, I'm flattering. Directly I heard you play.
What if it should prove that I'm none other than the son of His Majesty the Mikado?
The son of the Mikado? But what has Your Highness done? And why has Your Highness decided? And will Your Highness promise never to do it again?
Some years ago, I had the misfortune to captivate his catechism. An elderly lady in my father's court. She misconstrued my customary affability into expression of affection and claimed me in marriage under my father's law. My father, the Lucius Junius Brutus of his race, ordered me to marry her within a week, or else perish ignominiously on the scaffold. That night, I fled the court, and assuming the disguise of a second trombone, I joined the band in which you found me, and I had the happiness of seeing you again.
If you please, I think Your Highness had better not come too near. Laws against flirting are excessively severe.
But we are practically alone, and besides, nobody's looking at us.
Still, that doesn't make it right. The flirt is capital.
It is capital.
And we must obey the law.
Oh, deuce take the law!
I wish it would, but it won't.
If it were not for the law, how happy we might be.
Happy indeed.
If it were not for the law, we can now be sitting side by side, like this.
Instead of being obliged to sit half a mile off, like this.
We can be gazing into each other's eyes, like this.
Breathing sighs of unutterable love. Oh, like that.
With our arms around each other's waists, like that.
Yes, if it wasn't for the law.
If it wasn't for the law.
As it is, of course, we can do anything for time.
Not for the world.
Being engaged to Coco, you know.
Being engaged to Coco.
Is what I'll never.
cabinet. Wrapped up in that tiny little parcel. Really, hardly seems worthwhile.
Oh, matrimony!
Oh, now then, what is it? Can't you see I'm soliloquizing? You have interrupted an apostrophe, sir.
I am the bearer of a letter from His Majesty the Mikado.
A letter from Mikado, eh? What in the world can you have to say to me? It's in Japanese. Ah. Oh, here it is at last. The Mikado is struck by the fact that no executions have taken place in Tijiku for a year, and decrees that unless someone is beheaded within 1 month, the post of Lord High Executioner shall be abolished, and the city reduced to the rank of a village!
But that will involve us all in irretrievable ruin.
Yes. There's no help for it. I shall have to execute somebody at once.
The only question is, who should it be?
Well, seems unkind to say so. As you're already under the sentence of death for flirting, everything seems to point to, you.
To me? What are you talking about?
I can't execute myself.
Why not?
Why not? Because, in the first place, self-decapitation is an extremely difficult, not to say dangerous, thing to attempt. And in the second, it's suicide. And suicide is the capital offence.
That is so, no doubt. Yes, we might reserve that point.
It could be argued 6 months hence before the full court.
Besides, I don't see how a man can cut off his own head.
A man might try.
Even if he only succeeded in cutting his half off, that would be something.
It would be taken as an earnest hope. Your desire to comply with the imperial will.
No, pardon me, but there I am adamant.
As official headsman, my reputation is at stake, and I can't consent to embark on a professional operation unless I see my way to a successful result.
This professional conscientiousness is all very well for you, but it places us in a very awkward position.
My good sir, awkwardness of your position
is great itself compared with that man engaged in cutting off his own head.
I'm afraid that unless you can obtain a substitute.
A substitute?
Oh, certainly.
Nothing easier.
Hoover, I appoint you Lord High Substitute.
I should be delighted! Such a position would realise my fondest of dreams! But no, at any sacrifice, I must set bounds on my insatiable ambition.
I am so proud, if I am allowed, my family pride to be my guide. I volunteer to quit this sphere, instead of you in a minute or two. But family pride must be denied, and set aside, and mortified, and mortified.
My brain is and you for Tijiku, but in my face the benefit that I could use, the town would lose. Well, every man who ate his match of course he fell as best he can.
I heard one day a gentleman say that criminals who are cut in two can hardly feel the pain to steal, and so are slain without much pain. If this is true, it's jolly for you, your courage true to bid us adieu.
I've been so proud,
if I allow.
atmosphere. Instead of you in a fight or two.
And so, although I'm ready to go, yet dreadful extra disrespects did I neglect, without effect descending direct.
So I
object, and so,
although I wish to go, and plenty time to brightly shine and take the line of a hero by within it from a time. I must decline,
and go and throw what friends are for. Think you could forget Yum Yum so easily. After all,
What's more miserable than enough blighted life?
True.
Life without Yum Yum. Why, it seems absurd.
And yet there are a great many people in the world who have to endure it.
Poor devils, yes. You're quite right not to be of their number.
I won't be of their number.
Ah! Noble fellow!
I'll tell you how we'll manage it. Let me marry Yum Yum tomorrow, and then in a month you may behead.
No, pardon me, but I must draw the line at Yum Yum.
Very well, if you can draw the line, so can I.
Oh, no, wait!
Is that me?
Be free, devil! How can I consent to your marrying Yum Yum? I'm going to marry her myself.
My good sir, she'll be a widow in a month.
You can marry her then.
Well, yes. I can't see that. But my position during the next month will be most unpleasant.
Most unpleasant!
It's not half as unpleasant as my position at the end of it.
Oh, but... me. Well... Oh, right then. After all, it's only putting off my wedding for a month. But you won't prejudice her against me, will you? She's been educated to be my wife.
She's been taught to regard me as a wise and a good man. Now, I shouldn't like her views on that subject disturbed.
Trust me, she shall never learn the truth from me.
Thank you.
to you. Long life to you. Long life to you.
Thank you. when I meet you soon. Oh, tender through your disguising,
now comes the call.
Prepare yourself when you surprise me.
How for my fall?
No, Mr. Heath, it's quite bravado.
Thank you. perfecting my art in the Japanese way. Why, it is that I am so much more attractive than anyone else in the entire world.
Can this be vanity?
No, nature is lovely and rejoices in her loveliness. I am a child of nature. I take after my mother.
Yeah.
Then we'll efface it. We'll call each second a minute, each minute an hour, each hour a day, and each day a year. At that rate, we've about 30 years of married happiness before us.
And at that rate, this would be past 4 hours. Oh, Mary,
shoulder. Oh, thank you. I'm much obliged. Now,
kiss her!
Thank you. Oh, it's simple torture.
Come, come, there are. After all, it's only for a month.
No, it's no use deluding oneself with false hopes.
What do you mean?
My child, my poor child. How shall I break it to her? My little bride that was to have been.
Was to have been?
Yes. You never can be mine.
I'm so glad!
I've just ascertained that by the Mikado's law, when a married man is beheaded, his wife is buried alive.
Buried alive?
Buried alive. It's the most unpleasant death.
But whom did you get that from?
Oh, from Pubar. He's my solicitor.
But he made you believe it.
So I thought. So I consulted the Attorney General, Lord Chief Justice, Master of the Rolls, Judge Ordinary, and Lord Chancellor. They're all of the same opinion. Never knew such unanimity on a point of law in my life.
But wait a moment. This law has never been put in force.
Not yet. You see, flirting is the only crime punishable by decapitation. And married men never flirt.
Of course they don't. I quite forgot that. Well, then I suppose I may take it that my dream of happiness is at an end.
Thank you.
nothing more distressing than to have one's marriage broken off at the last moment. But you shan't be disappointed of a wedding. You shall come to mine!
It's awfully kind of you, but that's impossible.
Why so?
Because today I die.
Oh, what do you mean?
I can't live life without Yum Yum. This afternoon I perform the happy dispatch.
No, no, pardon me, but I can't allow that.
Why not?
Why, hang it all. You're under a contract to die at the hands of the public executioner in a month's time. You kill yourself. What's to become of me? Why, I should have to be executed in your place.
It would certainly seem so.
Now then, Lord Mayor, what is this?
Oh, my God, all the suites are approaching the city. And they'll be here in 10 minutes.
The Mikado has come to see whether his orders are being carried out. Now look here, you know. This is getting serious. A bargain's a bargain, and you really mustn't frustrate the ends of justice by committing suicide. As a man of honour and a gentleman, you are bound to die ignominiously at the hands of the public executioner.
Very well then, behead me.
What? Now?
Certainly, at once.
Chop it off! Chop it off! My good sir, I do not go about prepared to execute gentlemen at a moment's notice. Why? I've never even killed a blue bottle.
Still, as Lord Pie Blue Bottle, executioner.
My good sir, as Lord Pie Executioner, I've got to behead him in a month.
Not ready yet.
I don't know how it's done. I'm going to take lessons. I mean, to begin with a guinea pig and work my way through the animal kingdom until I come to a second trombone. Why, you don't suppose that as a humane man, I'd have accepted the post of Lord High Executioner if I hadn't thought the duties were purely nominal. I can't kill you. I can't kill anything. I can't kill anybody!
Come, my good sir. We all have our pleasant duties to discharge at times. After all, what is it? If I don't mind, why should you? Remember, sooner or later, it must be done.
Must it? I'm not so sure about that.
What do you mean?
Why should I kill you when making an affidavit that you've been executed will do just as well? Here are plenty of witnesses. Lord Chief Justice, Lord High Admiral, Commander-in-Chief, Secretary of State for the Home Department, First Lord of the Treasury. And Chief Commissioner of Police.
But where are they?
Oh, there they are. They'll all swear to it.
Won't you? Am I to understand? All of us high officers of state are inclined to perjure ourselves to ensure your safety?
Why not? You'd be grossly insulted as usual.
Why would you insult me cash down or at a date?
It'd be a ready money transaction.
Very well. Choose your fiction and the pile endorse it.
I'm badly tried.
But I tell you, the life like Yum Yum.
Oh, Yum 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 Yum. Bother Yum Yum! Here, Commissioner, go and fetch
Yum Yum.
Take Yum Yum and marry Yum Yum.
Hurry, go away and never come back again! I hiss you. Yum Yum, are you particularly busy?
Not particularly.
You have 5 minutes to spare?
Yes.
Then go along with this place to the Archbishop of Peterborough. He'll marry you at once.
Oh,
right, don't ask questions and do as I say. And that is to explain all.
Oh,
not for worlds! But here comes the Mikado, no doubt to ascertain whether I've obeyed his decree. And if he finds you here alive, I shall have the greatest difficulty in persuading you to be any Jew. Don't think that. But here he comes!
Hero, hero, soul of the one I love.
had been declared particularly correct.
But then nothing has so compared with those of the
house. I wish I'd been in time for the performance.
A tough fellow he was, too. A man of gigantic strength. His struggles were terrific. It really was a remarkable scene.
Describe it.
The criminal tried as he dropped himself in a state of wild alarm. With a frightful frantic fearful frown, I bare my big right arm.
I seized him by his little pigtail, and on his knees fell he. And he squirmed and struggled and gurgled and thus I grew
my skin.
Forget the frightful tree that shrieked me. As I gnashed my teeth, when from its sheath I drew my snake a sneeze.
He knew me well, he cannot tell a true or groundless tale. He always tries to utter lies, and every time he fails.
He shivered and shook as he gave a sign from a stroke he did at his home.
Circulation. It is the largest in the world.
And yet he's
flesh.
And is now masquerading in this town, disguised as a second trombone.
A second trombone!
Yes, would it be troubling you too much if I asked you to produce him? He goes by the name of...
Nanky
Poo.
It's quite easy.
Let me say, it's rather difficult. In point of fact, he's... gone abroad.
Gone abroad? His address?
Shelton!
Got it!
What about you and your big bright arm?
Yes, and your nigger knee.
Well, never mind that now. There's only one thing to be done. Nanky Poo hasn't started yet. He must come back to life again at once.
Ah, you eat.
Nanky Poo! I've good news for you. Dory breathed!
Too late for that now. I'm a dead man, and I'm off for my honeymoon.
Nonsense! A terrible thing has just happened. It seems you're the son of the Mikado.
Yes, but that happened some time ago.
Is this time for every bird's applause? Your father is here, and Mikatashan.
Your father? Mikatashan?
He wants you particularly.
And so...
Oh, but bless my heart, girl, what's that got to do with it?
Katashar claims me in marriage, but I can't marry her because I'm married already. Consequently, she'll insist on my execution. And if I'm executed, my wife has to be buried alive.
You see our difficulty.
Yes, but I don't know what to be done.
There's one chance for you. If you can persuade Katashar to marry you, she'll have no further claim on me. Consequently, I can come back to life without any fear of being executed.
I?
Marry Katashar?
I really think it's the only course.
My good girl, have you seen her? She's something appalling!
That's only her face. She has a gross hair on which people come miles to see.
And I am told that her right heel is much admired by connoisseurs.
My good sir, I must decline to pin my heart on any lady's right heel.
It comes to this. While Katashar is single, I prefer to be a disembodied spirit. When Katashar is married, the distance will be as welcome to me as the flowers in spring.
The flowers that bloom in the spring shall not be promised of merry sunshine. As the merry chant we sing, Trana, we welcome the hope that they bring, Trana, of the summer of roses and wine, of the summer of roses and wine. And that's what we mean when we say that a thing is welcome as flowers that bloom in the spring. Tra-la-la-la, tra-la-la-la, as flowers that bloom in the spring.
Tra-la-la-la, tra-la-la-la.
educated palate can appreciate me. I was educating his palate when he left me. When he is dead, and where shall I find another?
It takes years to train a man to love me.
Am I to go through the weary round again? And at the same time, implore mercy from you, who robbed me of my prey. I mean, my pupil. Just as his education was on the point of completion.
Not from me.
If there is aught of woman's mercy in your heart, turn not away from a love-sick suppliant whose every fibre thrills at your fine years. True it is that under a poor mask of disgust, I have endeavoured to conceal a passion whose inner fires are boiling the soul within me. But the fire will not be smothered. It defies all attempts at extinction, breaking forth. All the more it is not easily for its long restraint. Declares itself in words that cannot be weighed. That cannot be measured. That should not be too severely criticised. Tensha. I dare not whip your love, but I will not live without it. Darling.
You whose hands still reek with the blood of my betrothed!
Affection that's
an affecting tale and quite true. I knew the bird intimately.
Did you? Must be very fond of her.
His devotion was something extraordinary.
Mercy for cuckoo! Mercy for pretty things! The truth is not a You're a very good artist.
On this subject, you pray.